Welcome to the Texas Medical Center Library presentation on performing a literature search in Embase. In this video, we'll show you how to connect to the database from our library homepage, how to conduct a literature search, editing a search using limiters, and saving your search. So what is Embase? Embase is a biomedical and pharmacological database provided by the publishing company Elsevier that contains over 32 million citations to journal articles and is updated daily. Compared to Medline, Embase's collection is larger and its coverage is more international in scope. For those reasons, it is often included in comprehensive literature searches. Embase must be accessed from the Texas Medical Center Library homepage at library.tmc.edu. You'll find a link to the database under Core Resources. If you are logging in from outside the library, you may be prompted to log in via the library's authentication system, OpenAthens. If you have problems with the authentication process, please refer to our libguide on that topic. Once you've been authenticated, you'll be directed to the main Embase search screen. By default, the search screen is set to quick search mode. Before beginning a search in Embase, it's a good idea to create an Elsevier account so that you can save your search. For information on setting up an account, saving results, and running saved searches, please see our database libguide, which includes step-by-step instructions on that process. Let's use the following example research question. How are patients receiving hydroxychloroquine drug therapy monitored for the risk of retinopathy? The main concepts in this research question are hydroxychloroquine, retinopathy, and patient monitoring. It's essential to search each of these concepts separately using both subject headings and keywords. Subject headings are words that constitute a controlled vocabulary used to index articles in Embase. In Medline, subject headings are called MESH, or medical subject headings. In Embase, subject headings are referred to as MTREE terms. On the other hand, keywords are any words or phrases used to describe a particular concept. Unlike subject headings, the list of possible keywords for a particular concept can be quite long. Often, keywords are supplied by the authors of an article and can be found in the titles, abstracts, and keyword fields of the record. For more information on that topic, please watch our video on subject headings and keywords, in which we go into much more detail. Both subject headings and keywords are essential to conduct a thorough search of the literature, and our video explains why. Searching Embase in this way can be thought of as a building block approach. We start with the MTREE term search and add that to our keyword search with the Boolean operator OR. Adding those searches together results in the first building block of our literature review. The next building blocks consist of MTREE terms and keyword searches for all the remaining concepts in our research question. Once we have all the blocks in place, we can combine them with the Boolean operator AND to get our final list of results. To begin that process, let's go ahead and search MTREE for our first concept of hydroxychloroquine. At the top of the screen, click on MTREE and enter your search term. We're directed to the MTREE term hydroxychloroquine, an exact match. Clicking on the MTREE term allows us to see the index hierarchy, where we can see that hydroxychloroquine is included in many different index trees. On the right-hand side of the page, we can choose how we want to search the term. There are many options here, and for the sake of time, we'll just focus on a few. The major focus option will narrow results to articles in which hydroxychloroquine has been identified as the primary topic. This will exclude from your results any articles in which hydroxychloroquine appears as a minor topic. For this reason, it's generally recommended to avoid using this option in the beginning stages of your literature search, as doing so may eliminate potentially relevant articles from your results set. The explode option is used to expand your search to include more MTREE terms. Many subject headings can be broken down into more specific terms. The explode function allows us to capture all of these terms in a single search. In the case of hydroxychloroquine, there are no narrower terms below it, so we don't need to worry about whether to explode this term or not. The index term option allows you to search your chosen entry term without exploding or searching the term as a major focus. Since our term of hydroxychloroquine includes no narrower terms, this is the search option we will choose, but feel free to explore the other search modes also. Scrolling down a bit, we can also see a list of synonyms for your entry term. It might be a good idea to look through this list and identify any synonyms for hydroxychloroquine to include in your keyword search. From here, you can choose to display results, perform a drug search, or add this entry term to the query builder. Since I'm interested in adding another term to this group, I'll go ahead and choose the Add to Query Builder option. The entry term is added to the query box, and now I can search for another term. I want to search for the brand name of this drug, which is Plaquenil. Entering that term into the search box, I'm directed to use hydrochloroquine sulfate. The list of synonyms for this term includes a number of generic and brand drug names. If you want to be extremely exhaustive in your search, you could include more of these. For the sake of time, we'll just stick to using Plaquenil. So I'll add hydroxychloroquine sulfate to my query builder, and the database creates a syntax for me so that I can search both terms at the same time with OR. Notice that the database is using the Boolean operator OR. OR is used between synonyms or related terms. We're telling Embase to bring us articles that include the entry term of hydroxychloroquine or hydroxychloroquine sulfate. To execute the search, click on Show Results. This brings me to the results section of the database, where I can see the syntax of my most recent search and my search history. Now we need to add keywords for this concept. We have our entry terms and we know that Plaquenil is the brand name we want to use. I like to use both the entry terms and any synonyms or related terms in my keyword search. In order to search for keywords, I'm going to head over to the Search tab. I'm going to use the drop-down menu on the left to select the fields I want to search. I only want to search certain fields for these terms. These include the title field, abstract, and the keyword field. So I'm going to select title, abstract, author keywords from the Add Field menu here. Type out your list of keywords into the search box. Notice that I'm using the Boolean operator OR between each keyword or key phrase. I want the database to bring me articles containing any of these terms. For the keyword search, I'm going to use the terms hydroxychloroquine and Plaquenil. I'm not including hydroxychloroquine sulfate because that will be picked up by the keyword search for hydroxychloroquine. I'll separate these terms with OR and display the results. And that keyword search is added to our history in the results section. For a deeper explanation of database field searching, Boolean operators, truncation, and phrase searching, please visit our research guide on database search strategies. Now that I've conducted an entry search and keyword search on this concept, I'm ready to combine these lines together with OR. I'm telling the database to bring me articles that include this concept as an entry term or as a keyword. In this way, I can be confident that I'm capturing as many articles as possible on this particular concept. By searching entry terms, I can be certain my search is precise, and by searching keywords, I can be sure my search is as complete as possible. We've completed the first part, or building block, of our comprehensive literature search. Let's move on now to the next concept of retinopathy. Going back to entry search mode, I'm entering this term into the search box. There's an exact entry term for this as well. However, upon examining the index tree, I can see that there are a ton of narrow terms for this concept. I can either explode the term to include all of these narrow terms, or I can take some time and choose exactly which terms I want to include. Notice there are a couple of synonyms related to this term also. I can choose to add those to my keyword list if I feel they're relevant to my topic. You'll see dots next to entry terms that have no narrower terms associated with them. They represent the end of the line for that particular index tree, meaning there are no narrower terms below it. There are circles next to entry terms that do include narrower terms. click on any of these to see the narrow terms. For example, we can see that oxygen-induced retinopathy is a narrower term below experimental retinopathy. To return to our original M-tree term, just click on the link in the tree. If we explode retinopathy to include all narrow terms, we will include all the terms you see here in addition to all the narrower terms below those terms. For the sake of this demonstration, I'm going to go ahead and do that by choosing explode from the drop-down menu here, and then I'll display results. To search keywords, I'm heading back over to the search tab. I'm going to delete my previous search and type in my keywords for retinopathy. I'm inserting an asterisk after the H in retinopathy to get variations on the end of that word, like retinopathia or retinopathic, etc. This is called truncation. I'll also search for retinosis. That search is added to our history in the results section. Now we can combine these lines together with OR. We have now performed a comprehensive literature search for two concepts related to our research question, the hydroxychloroquine and retinopathy. Next, we'll perform a search for the concept of patient monitoring. I'll search the M-tree term for that term, and there is an exact match. I can see a number of narrower terms below patient monitoring, and I'm not interested in adding any of those to my search, so I'm going to make sure in the drop-down menu I select index term. I see there is a synonym here of patient surveillance. I'll add that to my keyword list. Now I'll do the keyword search by clicking on search, erasing my previous search string, and entering patient monitoring or patient surveillance. Now I've searched all three concepts using both M-tree terms and keywords. It's time to combine these concepts together with AND to instruct the database to bring us articles containing all of these concepts. To do that, I'm going to click on the line numbers next to my combined searches, and then combine those lines with the Boolean operator AND. My search retrieved about 36 results. All of these articles will contain the concepts of hydroxychloroquine, retinopathy, and patient monitoring somewhere in either the M-tree terms or in the titles, abstracts, or keyword fields. At this point, it's important to examine the abstracts and index terms of the articles you see to evaluate how well your search strategy worked. The abstract highlights where our keywords appear. Click on the title of the article to see where in the record our other terms appeared. As you screen your search results, make a note of any additional keywords or subject headings you might want to add to your search strategy. For instance, this article uses the M-tree term of practice guideline. That might be a good one to use in an OR relationship with patient monitoring. To edit a line, just position your cursor over the line you want to edit and click on the Edit button. A dialog box opens up and you can now edit this line. I want to add in the M-tree term of practice guideline. To do that, I'm going to type an OR and then just duplicate the syntax that was used for patient monitoring. So I'm putting practice guideline in single quotes, followed by a backslash, followed by DE. Click on Test. M-tree confirms that the syntax will work and gives you the option to accept the changes and update the search. Any lines of the search strategy that were affected by these changes will be marked with an asterisk. Click on the number to see the changes made. In our case, making that change bumped our results up by quite a bit. To limit your search results to a particular language or a year range, go up to the Quick Limits drop-down menu. Click on the button that says Only in English, and then click Search. A few articles have been excluded from our results set. To limit a particular year range, click on the Date drop-down menu and enter in the desired year range. I'm going to limit to the last 10 years. Click on Search. Several more articles were excluded from our results. To save this search, click on the button next to History and select every line in your history. click on Save. It's a good idea to create a folder for this search. Click on New and name your folder. Then give your search a name. It might be a good idea to use the date that you searched. And click Save. Your search history has been saved. If you have any questions about searching Embase, please contact a librarian.